Alright, hello everybody and welcome to another Anime Thoughts and Opinions video. Just one moment here while I get things set up. This is what happens when you press the record button before you're actually ready. This is going to be the first Anime Thoughts and Opinions video recorded on my main PC. Yay! Now, I have a lot of work to do. That's why I'm actually late to getting to this video. Normally, I do the Thoughts and Opinions videos the day of, usually right after I finish it. Sometimes I wait until the next day if I'm way too tired or something to do the video. This time, it's been about like two, almost 3 days since I've seen this anime, and I'm only just now getting to it. That's because I finished it the night prior to me getting the computer back up and running, and then by the time I woke up when I was going to do the video, I had to take the computer in, get it all fiddled out, and then bring it home and get things all fizzled out with it and stuff like that. That's why this one's actually kind of late. Actually, it's really late. And that's also probably why my analyst entry on this anime in particular is completely buggered. I don't even know if I marked it down right. I'll have to check that after. But it's buggered, I think, a little bit because I had to rush it. I had to, like, enter it within, like, 15 minutes. And normally I take 20 to 30, sometimes even more, to make my analyst entry when I complete an anime sometimes, depending on how much I have to say. So my analyst entry, just a quick heads up on this one, is kind of all over the place, and I don't think it's really that finalized. I'll try to rework it sometime in the future, though I'm not sure whenever that will be, if ever. So we're going to have to rely on the Thoughts and Opinions video to be my finalized opinions on your name, which is what we're going to be talking about in this episode. Now, before we actually get into it, there's a lot of stuff to say because I know a lot of people didn't actually watch my update video that I did recently on my analyst and watch list changes. So I'm going to be mentioning a few of those right here. I'm not going to mention all of them, but I'm going to mention them the next couple episodes that I do of Thoughts and Opinions for Animu. But it's important that you note, I do think it would be far more useful if you went and watched that video. If you can't find it, just go into the description and you should find a link to my Anime Thoughts and Reviews playlist and scroll down until you find the update video in that playlist. There's only one update video in that whole playlist as of right now, and there'll be more in the future. So if you're watching this in the future, then it's probably too late. There's multiple. It'll be the first one on the list if you want to hear all that stuff. But basically what's happening is now with a certain fix that has happened on Analyst, I have changed the watch schedule that I do. Before, I was forcing myself to watch full series in a day, whether it was, you know, 10 episodes to 26 episodes. I did this so that I could keep up my daily streak going in completing anime and keeping up my activity list on Analyst. I didn't use the watching or planning lists because doing that removed the ability for me to actually use the advanced rating system, essentially. So I could only ever use the advanced rating system when I went to complete an anime. But now, that advanced rating system stays there and you can edit it and change it, whether it's watching, whether it's completed, whether it's whatever. You can change it as many times as you want now. So, finally, I'm able to set things as watching, I'm able to set things as planning, and now I don't have to marathon a whole series if I don't really want to in a full day. I can watch an episode, or I can watch four episodes, or I can watch half a series, you know, I can watch it at my own pace. And that's really good right now because I'm really busy. So don't expect any Thoughts and Opinions videos to be coming out soon after this one, because I'm not going to be getting done with anything for a few days probably, because I'm busy with doing other stuff right now. But I'll at least watch an episode or two each day if possible. Now as for the schedule changes on how I'm watching things, I'll get this out of the way as quickly as possible. But before, as you'll know if you were watching my videos in the past, you'll know that I came up with this thing that I was doing because I have such a list. I was going to pick one by choice from the list. So I'd look at it and say, oh, I think this one's interesting, and I watch it by choice. Then after I'm completed with it, I pull one out of the bowl at random because all of my entries go into the bowl. And then I watch that one. Then I rinse and repeat. So I pick one by choice, pick one at random, pick one by choice, pick one at random, etc., etc. I started breaking those rules over the past 2 weeks because I was on so many time crunches and I was just trying to get something finished in a day each time. So I was always just picking and choosing and barely was doing the one by choice, one by random thing. I was doing it sometimes, but it was very rare. Well, now I can go back onto that. Since I don't have to do the rush thing anymore and stress out over it, I can easily just set up what I'm watching next based off of my choice and then based off of random. But it's changed. Now I have up to each time I do it, each stage, an analyst, I have 4 planned anime that I'm watching. And I chose all 4 of them right away, okay? 2 of them were chosen by my choice. So 2 of them I picked out of my list by my choice. The other 2 were pulled out of the bowl at random. Now, you guys as the viewers aren't going to know which ones are the randoms and which ones are the choices. But if you want to see which ones I'm working on, go over to my analyst page, click on my anime list, and you can go to see what I'm watching. And if you scroll all the way down to the bottom, you'll see what's planned. Now, of course, there's only 3 in the planned section because I've already started watching one. And the idea is once I'm done watching all 4, then I will pick another 4, 2 by choice, 2 at random, rinse and repeat. That's how I'm doing it now. That way it can give you guys a heads up on what the next 4 anime I'm watching are. Though, the only bendy rule that I can do is I get to choose to watch the 4 in whatever order I want. So even though 2 of them are random and 2 of them are by choice, I can watch them in whatever order. I can watch both of the ones I chose by choice first, I can watch the one I want to watch the most first, or I can watch the ones I'm least interested in first. Stuff like that. Okay, so 6 minutes in, and I think we got that heads up out of the way. I'll be trying to do this heads up in the next couple episodes as well, but keep in mind the next couple episodes probably aren't going to be coming for quite a while. Now, as for the disclaimers, the usual disclaimers that we always deal with, this will contain spoilers to Your Name, so I do not recommend watching or listening to this video if you want to stay unspoiled when it comes to this anime. In the description below, you will find multiple links. You will find a link to my analyst page where you can see any and all of my analyst and anime tracks, track stats. You can see all of the stats there. Finally, it's updated itself now. I unbroke my broken account, and all of my stats are finally tracked on there. You can see a full list of all my completed anime and such. Also, you can take a look at my favorites list on there. Where you can see my favorite anime, my favorite characters, favorite staff, etc., etc. However, one big note that I wanted to point out as well is on my analyst page, you can only have a maximum number of favorites listed on your front page. And I have a maximum amount already reached for my favorite characters. Keep in mind, what you see on my front page isn't my full list of favorites. I definitely recommend, if you do want to look at my favorites list, go to the favorites tab on my profile instead of looking at the front page. There, then you can see the full list of my favorite characters in the order that I had ordered them. You'll also find a link to my Twitter, where I usually post sneak peeks to the next anime I'm going to be doing, as well as, of course it's not going to be a sneak peek if you guys just look on my analyst planned section, but I'll probably still try to post something over there. We'll see, I don't know. And you can also find other like news posts and updates and tidbits on Twitter as well. You will also find a link to my YouTube Anime Thoughts and Reviews playlist. This contains every single one of my Anime Thoughts and Opinions videos in chronological upload order. And you can also now find my analyst and anime update videos in this playlist as well, also in chronological upload order. And last but not least, this is not a full or detailed review. It's not professional in any way whatsoever. I don't follow a script. The only thing I follow is my notes. And I just kind of sit back and I ramble and I just talk about whatever it is we're talking about. So this isn't a video that you're really meant to watch. It's more or less something that you're meant to sit back and listen to while you do whatever it is you do in your daily life. Anyways, that's going to bring all of the disclaimers to an end. So we can finally get in and talk about this. Now, Your Name is not a full-fledged series, it is an anime. It is a film. I believe it's about an hour and 40-something minutes long, if I remember correctly. I don't think I wrote it down, so... No, I didn't write it down. And I picked it out because I noticed it was a film. It's kind of like the same reason why I picked out A Silent Voice a week or two back, because I was on a bit of a time crunch, and I was like, well, I'll just find something that's shorter, and I found a film, and then I realized I just watched one of the greatest things I'd ever fucking seen. And Your Name also seems to have a similar effect, though not as much, in my opinion. So, excuse me, something stuck up my ass. All right. First of all, let's talk about the genres, as I usually do. There are 3 genres tied to this on Analyst: romance, drama, and supernatural. Okay, supernatural? Yeah, there's supernatural bits in this. Probably not the supernatural that you're probably what most people would think of right away, but it definitely is supernatural. Drama? Absolutely. Lots of drama. And romance? I would like to say yes, but it's another one of those really unsatisfying romances. And I think that's also one of the reasons why I probably didn't enjoy this as much as I wanted to. It's clearly a romance, but nothing ever comes to it. There's never ever a climax to the romance. There's never actually... There's only one real heartwarming kind of tear-jerking scene that happens near the end of the series. That's about it to the romance section. So I'd like to stay neutral on the romance and say yeah and no at the same time. And that's it for that. Okay, now, we're going to be focusing on two different characters only. I'm gonna screw everyone else. And I don't know how long this video is. It might not even be as long as my normal videos. We're going to be focusing on the two main characters, Mitsuha and Taki, I believe are their names. I could be fucking those up, but because I don't really remember. I believe Taki's the boy and Mitsuha is the female who play the main roles in the film. Now, I didn't know what to expect when going into this, so it was another blind walk-in where I just went into it knowing nothing except the genres that were tied to it, and that was it. So when I was watching it, I thought it was just going to be a romance between two characters, that they meet each other in school, and it's a typical old, you know, cheesy romance. And that's actually not the case, because it goes real anime at some point. And when I say when it goes real anime, that's when I mean tragedy fucking strikes. Because what fucking anime doesn't have to have some sort of bullshit tragedy that happens that makes you want to kill yourself? Because, of course, that's what happens in this. And it's some... It's... Wow, okay. I think I should talk about... Before we talk about, like, each of the little things, we should probably talk about the visuals and the soundtrack and all that kind of stuff. Also, that's another thing. I have added the soundtrack to my advanced rating system because you can actually edit and add more categories to your advanced rating on Analyst now. I added soundtrack, and this is the first anime on my Analyst list that I had rated the soundtrack separately to audio. So I just thought that was a fun fact. Okay, fine, whatever. The visuals are probably... I don't know how to explain this. I want to say they're probably some of the best that I have ever seen, but not in the sense of just how they look. It's more or less in how it's... There, okay, there are scenes. There's a ton of scenes where I can't tell if it's 2D or CG, and they're both mixed. I can't tell the difference, and that's a good thing. That's like, holy shit. Because whatever they did, it doesn't look cheesy, it doesn't stick out like a sore thumb, and it just makes my mind go as I'm looking at it. And there's also tons of scenes where you get to see various views and landscapes, and those are just breathtaking, every single one of them. You see Tokyo multiple times, you see countryside multiple times, all of them are just amazing looking. And of course, all the other animation is really, really good. It's top-notch. Like, this is what I would expect from a film, and then some. This is definitely beyond what I would normally expect from a film when it comes to quality and that sort of stuff. But there's one thing I wanted to point out, and it's both about the visuals and about the music. Now, I'm talking specifically about the lyric to music. Now, I didn't look this up, okay, so I don't know for sure. I could be talking out my ass. This is purely based off of my memories. So somebody in the comment section is probably going to have to tell me whether or not my thoughts are spot on or off. Now, I haven't seen this anime since, shit, I think 2014. It was either early 2014 or late 2013 when I watched the anime in question. It was one of the first anime that I had watched, and it was one of the last ones that I had watched before I slipped. And then when I watched this, so it's been many, many years since I saw it, but I swear to fucking God, the whole time I'm watching this anime, the whole time, this film, ever since I started it, all the way to the end, I was like, is this just Anohana, but in film form? The characters' art designs scream exactly what I remember from that. And there are various lyric songs that I fucking swear to God is the same guy that sings the opening song to Anohana. But again, I didn't look it up because I didn't want to spoil it for myself right away. I was thinking that from the whole way through. The eye design, various times when a character will, like, specifically when Mitsuha, when she's standing there, and she's standing at an angle, and then she looks kind of at a diagonal angle, and you can see her eyes and stuff like that. It's like, holy shit, that's just Anohana. It looks exactly like it. Either it's a coincidence, or someone who worked on the art design also worked on that anime ages ago. And same goes with the music. Now, the music, the non-lyric music, and I'm not much of a fan of the lyric music in this. It's good music, but I've never been a fan of I don't know what you call that type of music. I like lyric music, but I never liked the opening for Anohana, for example. I think it might have something to do with the male singer and watch it be a female singer, and now I'm just talking out my ass again. I'm more attached to female singers in emotional scenes rather than male singers. And they play these songs during various emotional scenes throughout the film. It didn't really work for me. The normal soundtrack, however, works really, really well. I wouldn't say it's anything amazingly memorable, but it's definitely something worth mentioning, and it is good, especially during the scenes where it needs to be good. And in those scenes where it needs to be good, it is good. Now, I've got various things here, and I think before we actually talk about the story itself, I wanted to mention something that I noticed. There is so much product placement and so many companies in this that I guess they got permission to use. Like, every single scene you see, there is some sort of product placement, and there's some sort of, oh, there's Sony, you know, or there's some big car brand that goes by, right? But they can get all of these extremely expensive and top-of-the-line companies to be shown in film. Now, maybe it has to do with where the film, with who actually produced the film. Maybe they had more of the rights. I don't know. You get all this shit, but they can't get the rights or permissions to use Pocky. Fucking Pocky. They have to use Talkie. I thought that was funny, because there's only one scene where you see them eating Talkie, and it's just for like 2 seconds, and all you see is the box, and all you see is the T-O-C, and then the top part of the K, so you know that that's just supposed to be their version of Pocky. I just thought that was funny. Out of all the things, they can't get this really cheap, short, you know, shitty honey biscuit stick covered in crappy chocolate that I eat all the fucking time because for some reason it's just addicting. They can't get that thing in the film. I don't know. It's just a stupid fun fact that I wanted to point out. Not a fun fact, you twat. It's just a stupid funny thing that I wrote down in my notes because I noticed it. Now, let's talk about, since my analyst entry is kind of all over the place, I think we should probably talk about my thoughts and feelings. Something smells like shit. Something about my thoughts and feelings towards the film itself. I rated it a 9.1 on analyst. Now, that's a good rating. That makes it the second highest rated film on my all of my analysts, and that makes it like in the top 10 of my top rated anime on all of my anime stuff, I think. Now, it's above Space Battleship Yamato. Wait, no, that's an OVA, you fucker. It's above Girls in Panzer the Film, but below A Silent Voice on my analyst entry currently. Now, the reason for that is for some reason, is I think most of the rating that I gave this anime comes from the visuals itself. And that's pretty much it. Like, for example, with A Silent Voice, which is the highest rated item on my entire analyst right now, the visuals there got a high rating, but it was also because of how special the film was and how just, it's just a feels trip from beginning to end, and it's a really good one. And I like the payoff at the end, mostly. Even though there I was also kind of a little bit, you know, on edge about the romance thing, and I didn't exactly agree with it fully. But that's why that one was rated so high, because it did everything in such a special way. This one deals with the thing that I don't like, and they could easily have fixed this problem for me. Now, this is more pet peeve for me, so keep in mind what I'm about to complain about is definitely something I understand is probably just an issue with me, and not anyone else. But this is a problem, this is a pet peeve that I have with anime, and it's not just anime, but it's always done in anime very, very often. And it's something I just don't really enjoy. And that has to do with memory alteration and memory loss. I cannot stand it if it doesn't play a role that I can agree with. Now, they could have easily done all of the memory stuff they do in this anime right here, normally. But if at the very end... Okay, I don't know, I smelled something. Somebody must be making food. But if at the very end they actually did a good payoff, where it's as if, you know, their memories aren't fucked, then I probably would have been A-okay with it and I would have accepted it. Unfortunately, you don't get that confirmation. You just get I guess I'll talk about the ending later, so I won't mention that now. This whole thing is just basically about memory alteration and memory loss. But the only thing that is interesting about it is the way that the story works. So, I guess now is as good a time as any to get into it. The story focuses on Mitsuha and Taki, two different characters. They live in two different parts of Japan. One, Mitsuha lives off in the countryside in some little tiny village, and Taki lives in, I just realized his name is also like the Taki Paki. Anyways, Taki lives off in Tokyo. You know, and they're all good and bad at their own things and stuff like that. And it's all like, ugh. But they seem to both have these faint memories of someone else, and they don't know why. And they can't remember, like, the previous day, so they don't remember what they were doing. But apparently they were up to weird shit and stuff. Like, you even get the scene where when Mitsuo wakes up in the first... one of the first scenes of the film, she looks down at her boobs and she just starts squishing them. I'm like, what? Is that what females do? Because I didn't realize it at the time, but of course you learn why that is later on. Essentially, what's happening is, for some odd reason, these characters are switching between each other, and it's triggered by sleep. And essentially, they become their other self. And at first, you know, they don't know why, they don't understand what's going on or anything like that. They just think it's just a thing, right? It's just a dream. Until after a few days go by, a few weeks or whatever, they start waking up, and they realize that the past days that they can't remember actually were happening. And finally, and this is something I really liked, this is something that I think they could have done really, really well. And this is one of the scarier things, right? But they start working together, essentially. So once they start figuring it out, they start communicating with each other. For example, they'll write things on their arms or on their hands, or they'll write things in a journal or on a diary or something to give you notification, to give the other person notification so that when they wake up, they know what's going on, or they know what not to do when they get inside their body, you know, stuff like that. And I thought that was really cool. As they're starting to work together, they're trying to fight against it by, like, you know, just dealing with it, but dealing with it in the way that they can kind of help each other. See, that was really fun to watch. But see, shit gets plot twisty when there is a comet that passes over. So we go all Charlotte on this ship. And there's a comet that passes over. It's supposed to be passing really close to Earth. And it's the comet that you see in all of the promotional material for this anime and stuff like that. Well, actually, you probably can't tell it's a comet. It looks more like a shooting star. What's the difference? There is a difference, actually. But, it comes over and it's this beautiful scene. All of the scenes with the comet in it is just breathtaking. It's amazing looking. Like, that right there could just win awards. It passes over and you see it from Mitsuo's point of view. And you see it kind of split in two. And it's like, ooh, ah, pretty. And then it zooms in on her face and she gets this shocked look. And then it just cuts to black and you're like, well, what the hell? And then all of a sudden there's no more switching. And we focus on Taki's point of view. And I was like, what the hell? Why is there no switching anymore? What's going on? What, you know what? Hello? Why all of a sudden now is there no switching? And I was like, okay, well, maybe it would make sense. And I was like, okay, this is what the anime is going to be about. So I thought it was the comet was what, kind of like with Charlotte, it was what was causing the supernatural powers. And then it pops down, and then it was because the comet was passing by, or in the process of passing by, that they were switching bodies. And then now that it has passed by, or so I thought, there's no more switching. And then I thought the rest of the film was going to be focused on both of these characters trying to find each other in person, because they had kind of grown to like each other in a way. And then they would meet up at the end, there'd be all this, you know, fancy-dancy romance stuff, and then it would end happy. Well, that's not what happens. That's what starts to happen, however, because... Excuse me, that's what starts to happen. Oh my god. What the fuck? Okay. So, Taki takes it into his own hands and does the number one thing that he should be doing, and he starts to look for Mitsuo. So he remembers, you know, because he remembers her, what he saw through her eyes, and so he's trying to remember the town and stuff. And because he wants to be an architect when he grows up, I guess, he is really good at drawing architecture and landscaping and stuff like that. And so he tries over and over. You get this scene where you can see that he's just starting over and over again, failing and failing and failing, but he keeps going until he gets it done, where he tries to draw a picture of the village that she lived in, of this town or whatever that she lived in, until he finally got one. It's got this big, like, sort of like crater-shaped lake with a water in it. Well, obviously if it's a lake, and the city's kind of surrounding it or on one side of it and everything. And he finally gets it done, and he and a couple of his friends decide to group up and go off and look. And I guess he's just going to search around all of Japan until he finds this damn place. He has no idea where it is. He has no idea where to try and look. He doesn't even think to ask anybody. So, obviously, you know, he's got a few brain cells missing there. But he just gets on a train, and they're off. And I was like, okay, this is fun. This is really, really fun. This is good. And, you know, that would kind of be boring, I can understand, to a lot of people. But that kind of thing is perfectly fine for me. But things do take that tragedy turn, which is... And this is actually really, really fun. This is one of those plot twists that I didn't see coming, and I was like, what the fuck? But then, of course, the memory shit kicks in, and then it's like, well, unfortunately, they ruined it for me. But anyways, what ends up happening is they stop at, like, this little restaurant, this little, like, almost like what you would call a truck stop in the United States. And they sit down just to grab a little bite to eat or a little drink or something like that. And he pulls out of his backpack the picture of this village that he drew. And the waitress walks up to him and is like, oh, that's, you know, that's that place. And she calls over the chef or whatever, who comes out, and he's all like this old grumpy looking man. And he looks down at it and he's like, brings back memories. Now, keep in mind, I'm saying it in English, but I was watching the sub version. I have to point that out every time I do one of these videos now, because a lot of people think I'm watching the dubbed versions. I'm not. I'm watching the sub versions, damn it. He looks down at it and he's got this, like, you know, and he's like, that brings back memories. And I was like, oh, wow, he lived there when he was a kid. See, all you had to do, Taki, was just ask somebody. And then, of course, Taki flips out and he's like, holy shit, you know, okay, where's the way to it? How do I get there? And stuff like that. And then, of course, that's where it's like, where the old man's like, yeah, well, you know, where have you been? Have you been living under a rock? Because that village was destroyed by a comet 3 years ago. Like, what? You fucking what, mate? That's the shit. Like, that's, I was like, my brain melted at that point. Normally, a lot of times they try to do plot twists in these anime that I watch. It's always super easy to see it coming from episode one, right? Sometimes, not always. This one, I never once expected. And maybe that had something to do with the fact that I had no idea what it was about going into it. And I was kind of reacting to it as, and learning as I was watching and stuff like that. So by the time that I had learned this, it was too late and I couldn't think of anything happening. Like, not once did I think that the comet actually hit the village. But yeah, apparently it did. The shard that broke off earlier when it breaks in two, it's actually destroying the village. And they go there and you see it. And there's this second massive crater and the entire town is just obliterated. Which is weird. And this is where it kind of doesn't make much sense. So why were they connected with each other? And, okay, they try to explain it, but they explain it in that spiritual kind of vague, you know, kind of crappy way. So that they try to explain it themselves, but it still doesn't make any sense whatsoever. It's one of those deals. It's explained through Mitsuha's point of view. Anyways, so, of course, but he's got all of his entries, you know, he's got all, like, the diary entries that Mitsuha made when she was inside of his body, right? Okay, so he looks those up, and of course, it does the diary, it does the future diary thing, and they all just switch and change to different entries, and suddenly it's as if she never existed. And I was like, okay, see, now this is where I'm gonna start having a problem. I don't like that shit. I don't like this memory alteration shit. But it's fine, because he still remembers himself. Okay, so that's fine, but nobody else, it's gonna be harder for him to, for other people to believe him, right? And it's just like, what the fuck? I don't understand how this works. 3 years apart from each other, you know, she's dead, and her whole village is dead, but apparently they were still able to connect to each... What? I don't know. You know, I don't fucking know. Oh, wait, okay, I think maybe one of the reasons why they could connect, actually thinking of it now, is because they actually met prior, if I remember correctly, to the comet hitting. But you don't learn that until right at the end of the series. She actually came to look for Taki. This is where it gets really confusing. Because she actually came to look for Taki before they were doing all this. Like, for example, it's basically almost like two parallel timelines. And one timeline is out of whack. So she, you know, after all this connecting stuff, she knows Taki, and she goes back, she goes to Tokyo quickly to try and find him. And she finds him, but he doesn't know her, because it's actually before he started connecting with her in that way, right? So this is, it's almost as if she went back in time almost, but she didn't, right? It's really hard to explain, but that's one of those really confusing things. I think maybe that's one reason why they were still able to connect to each other even after death or something stupid. I don't know, whatever, fucking stupid piece of shit. Anyways, finally, there's this whole deal where they travel to this sacred place and stuff like that, and this is kind of the key. And Mitsuha decides that she, you know, she's going to try to avoid the comet. She's going to try to save her village and stuff like that. And you get a lot of these scenes. You know, her dad is like a cock. He's like a mayor or something, like a spokesperson. He's really strict and he just doesn't listen to her and stuff like that. But she's getting pissed. And I think Taki ends up becoming her at some point. And I don't... Because there's a point where they no longer connect with each other, and they have their last time together, right, where they're next to each other. And this is that heartwarming scene I was talking about earlier.
But there is, they're
trying to get the town evacuated, but they're failing at it, right? And so Taki ends up running all the way to this destroyed village, because in his timeline, the village is destroyed. But in Mitsuha's timeline, the village is still there, and the comet is on the way. You know, it's sunset, it's coming, the sun's setting, and the comet's on its way, and stuff like that. You know, so time, and I was feeling kind of tense, because there's not much time left, and there's a lot at stake. You know, is this, because I was, the whole time, because I was thinking, I was just watching Anohana the film, I was expecting this to end in the worst fucking way possible. Because whoever made that shit is a demented motherfucker. Twilight happens, which is that they actually have this mention in school about Twilight earlier on in the film, and it actually plays a role later on. It's where things don't even seem human for just a few seconds, where it's not day and it's not night. And when it hits that, their two timelines meet and they can see each other together, even though their timelines are completely out of whack compared to each other. And they have just a few seconds with each other. And I was like, stop. You know, it's really cute. I really like it. I like what Mitsuha does about her boobs and stuff like that. But it was like, stop talking about that shit. You guys got more stuff to worry about. And so the thing, and because they keep forgetting stuff every time they wake up, they decide that they'll write each other's names on each other's hands. So Taki takes Mitsuha's hand and writes something on it. And then Mitsuha goes to take Taki's hand and starts writing, but then she just disappears. Bam, right there, before she even gets to really start writing. That was kind of tear-jerky right there. And of course, then he just had, you know, she runs off in her timeline. She's still trying to kick ass, even though there's not much time left. And I was like, there's no way she's going to get everyone out of town in time. The comet is like 2 feet away, right? Now, how is she going to be able to convince her father this time? But, She charges in there, into where her dad's at, and you can tell that her dad's just like, you fucking bitch, why are you back here? Like, he's so pissed at her. But she goes in there with this stern, like, I'm gonna kick some serious ass if you don't listen to me. Look. And then it just cuts. It just cuts. and this is something I don't like, honestly. But it cuts, and you see the comet hitting the town. And they do that thing where they cut all the music and all the sound effects, and you just get to watch the visuals fly by as you watch the town get ripped to shreds. That kind of stuff I like. That's good for shock value. They do that in a lot of stuff. I like that kind of thing. That's cool. But it wasn't too shocking to me. Now, the visuals of the destruction is, again, some of the best I've ever seen. But you fucking see the town just a huge shockwave, rip buildings apart, ripping bridges apart. You just see everything get obliterated. But the number one thing that caused me to be like, sort of, well, I mean, it's kind of too obvious what they did here. They did that classic thing where they try to trick the viewer into thinking one thing, but they did it. But it's they did it too plainly that it was too obvious from the first moment. What they try to do is they try to make you think that the village was destroyed, because they show it destroyed. You don't get to see them leaving, and they do it a split second after you see her with her father, right? But they further enhance this because after it, I think something like 10 years, 8 years or something like that, 8 to 10 years have passed by, and you see it from Taki's point of view, and you still see the village destroyed and everything, but you don't hear anything about it, and Taki's just going off doing his own thing and stuff like that, right? You know, so again, they make it really seem like it just didn't work. But like I said, they made it too obvious, because it obviously did work. They're just trying way too hard to trick us into thinking that it didn't work. Because in the destruction scene, you see absolutely nobody. There's nobody on the streets, there's nobody on the bridge, there's nobody in the buildings when you see them get obliterated. Nothing. And then they do the next like 8 to 10 year thing jump to make you kind of more tense and on edge about, oh no, you know, one of those deals. But of course Taki ends up, he's in one shop at some point in there. The two friends of Mitsuha are in that same shop. And he of course looks over at them and he's like, they're familiar for some reason, but I don't know why. Also, both of these characters cry at some point for no reason. They don't know why either, and it's because of how fucking depressing this story is. Like, if this story ended the way that I just said, then yeah, this would have been an awful anime, but an awful anime in a good way. It's one of those deals where I would hate it so much because of how depressing it is. But he just goes on. He does his normal thing. But he still he feels like something's missing. He keeps saying, you know, something's missing from my life. It's, you know, it's as if I dreamed something and then woke up and something's missing somewhere. But I don't know what. Right. And so obviously, and this is the thing. It's like, all, and this is the thing that I don't like. When they wrote their names, or when they're sitting there before, you know, after Twilight had ended, when they go running off in their separate directions, right? After having remembered each other's names and tried writing them down, they're both running in their opposite directions in their different timelines, repeating the name over and over again. And there was another anime that did this exact same thing, and I fucking hated it because I think it's stupid as hell. They're running, and he's saying, Mitsuha, 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 I won't forget. Who are you? Who am I not forgetting? Literally, in the same 2 seconds. That shit is stupid, in my opinion, and I don't enjoy it one bit. That's what I was talking about earlier when I talked about the premise of memory alteration and memory loss, something I don't like. And it's not like a health issue, it's not like a mental issue that this person has, where they have a disability and they have memory issues. See, that's a different story play. That's something that works. But this is just one of those cases where it's like, oh, we're going to forget just because this supernatural timeline's all out of whack shit. You know, and of course, he doesn't see the name on his hand because she didn't get to write all of it. And what about Mitsuha? What he wrote on her hand, right? Well, she's remembering, and then she forgets, so she looks at her hand and it says, I love you. See, now that was kind of a nice scene. I liked that. He didn't write her name. That's the only romance scene you get in the whole fucking anime, by the way. He didn't write his name. He instead wrote, I love you on it. And I thought that was really, really touching. And of course, she forgets, but she knows that whoever wrote it is important, so she just got back up because she had tripped and fallen. She gets back up and she just takes off running to find her father to get everybody evacuated from the town as fast as possible. And of course, after all of that, after you go through a few scenes with Taki, you know, eight, whatever, however many years in the future, like, you see they are actually older, too. That's stupid. I fucking hate that shit, too. I hate time jumps. God damn it, man. Anyways. They're on the subway trains together, or they're on separate subways, or I guess they're not subways, but they're on separate trains, and they see each other, and they're like, oh, I know you, oh, I know you, you know, one of those deals, and they get off, and they're looking for each other, and they're chasing around all over the fucking Tokyo looking for each other, you see, from both of their points of views, and then finally, they meet up in this alleyway, on these stairs, and then all of a sudden, they're just like, oh, well, I'll keep walking. What? You just spent the better part of, like, the last 30 hours looking for each other nonstop, and then you finally find each other, look at each other, and then turn the other way and start walking away. I guess they were nervous. But Taki grows a pair, and he turns around, and he says, have I met you before? And she looks up at him and says, I believe we have. And that's where it ends. Stupid ending. Like, that's actually an ending I'm very unsatisfied with. Because, it plays part with the memory alteration, the memory loss thing. They know that they know each other, or they believe they do, but they don't know, you know, they don't have the memories of them actually knowing each other. One of those deals, right? So it ends where they're both questioning the fact that they know each other. Now, of course, it ends in a way that is happy, where you know that they do get together after the film, and you know that they do end up probably having a family and stuff like that, and they become very close. But it's the fact that it ends that way, playing a role with the memory alteration, because obviously everyone in the village had survived, like I had said. You see the village still destroyed, but everyone had gotten away. And then it ends like that. You don't get to see the romance finally come to a head. You don't get to see that satisfying ending where maybe they have most of their memories or something like that, because they don't even say each other's fucking names. That's how little of the memory they show there. And then you don't get any post-credit screen. So normally, like, they would end something like, there have been other anime that end unsatisfying like that too, but then there's a post-credit screen that adds on like a few extra seconds or even a few extra minutes of just either that scene or a future scene that makes me feel much more satisfied about it. No post-credit screen here whatsoever. I watched all the way through the credits, all the way through to the end, nothing. And then, what is this saying? Right, okay, and then of course I wrote down a few things about romance not coming to a head. They never hug, there is no kiss, there doesn't have to be a kiss, but kissing is like, you know, that's the top of the line romance right there. If right at the end they finally met each other, and they knew each other with their memories, and they kissed, and then it ended, that would have been a satisfying ending. Because you would get to see it and you would know for sure. Something like that. Instead of having to use your own imagination to come up with it. Okay. Now. I've talked about the whole story and my opinions on them and the things I liked and didn't like. There was only really one or couple things I didn't like, and the biggest one being the memories thing, right? This is only 9.1. It would probably, if the visuals weren't as good as they were, it would probably be like a mid to early or mid to low 8 range, so it would still be very highly rated. But it didn't actually make my favorites list. Now I've rated things highly before, like for example the Violet Evergarden special. That's a 9.2, but that didn't make my favorites list. But that's because that's a special. You know, specials and stuff like that. But when it comes to films and TV completed anime and OVA anime and stuff like that, they can make my, they usually always do. In fact, I think this is probably the first item, I think, with the exception of maybe one other thing I might be forgetting, but I believe that your voice, now I'm completing a silent, or now I'm combining a silent voice and your name together. Your name, as far as I'm aware, is the first, or at least second, anime to reach 9 rating that doesn't go on my favorites list. And, I mean, I don't really have to explain why it didn't, because I already explained the reasons why it wouldn't have, or whatever. And that brings my notes to a list. There's nothing else that brings my notes to a list. That brings my notes to an end. There's nothing else on my notes to talk about. I got it all talked about. I'm all finished with it now. And yeah. Now, the quality of this, of course, after I finish the anime and stuff like that and make my entry, I look at, like, the ratings on analysts and stuff. I don't read reviews. I still stay away from reviews until I do my own thoughts and opinions, but I do look at, like, the percentages of the ratings of the anime itself. And this is, it's much like a silent voice in that it's one of those deals where normally when you look at a rating for an anime, no matter what it is, it's always something that starts low. You know, when you go from, like, the 10%, the 10 rating all the way up to the 100 ratings, you see it starts really low and then it goes up in, like, the 70, 80, and 90 range, and then it goes down again around the 100 range. But with a silent voice, it went just up the whole way. Every single rating percentage just went up. It shot through the roof. The same thing goes with your name. It starts with, like, nobody on the planet or their mother is rating this thing any lower than an 80%. And then you just see it go shoot straight up, and of course the highest is the 100% range. You know, so it's again one of those deals. A lot of people rated this. Now, I haven't rated anything 10 out of 10. All right. None of my anime that I've watched, even the ones that I consider to be something I would die and go into in the afterlife and sell for all eternity, live there, that is definitely still not a 10 out of 10. There may never be a 10 out of 10 because I think it's going to have to, like, do something crazy special to kick off a 10 out of 10 for me. Crazy, crazy special. But anything above a 9, anything 9 or up, that's basically my 10, essentially. So if you see something that's rated 9, that's essentially me just the same as rating it as a 10 out of 10 as someone else. Now anything below a 9, you know, an 8, then that's your normal 8s. And then the 7, that's your normal 7s, etc., etc. And anything below a 7, that's when I was getting really, really bored with it. You know, and then anything below a 6 is when, ugh, that's when you're talking stuff I really didn't enjoy at all. Too much. So this is still very highly rated. And even if, you know, and like I said, it's only a 9.1 because of the visuals. Otherwise, it would have been a mid to low 8 range rating. And even then, that's still a really high rating. So regardless, I still really enjoyed the film a lot. Now, in terms of quality, compared to A Silent Voice, I think this one probably has a lot better in animation and visual quality. But A Silent Voice has a much better story, in my opinion, because it's just far more touching. It doesn't have any of the plot twist or anything. Because keep in mind, while I don't like the memory shit, I do like the idea of the story. I like the idea that they were in two different completely timelines, because that caught me off guard, and it was hard to follow, but it was a good hard to follow. I like that kind of stuff. But other than that, I thought A Silent Voice was just more touching. And that was another film. And the only reason I'm comparing these two is because they're both two recent films that I've seen. Both of really high quality and production value. And because on my list, I wrote them down at the same time. They're right next to each other, which probably means that whenever these were recommended, because much like with A Silent Voice, I have no idea where this was recommended to. Apparently, it was only recommended once. And it was recommended right next to A Silent Voice, which probably means that it was recommended at the exact same time as A Silent Voice in the same comment or Discord suggestion or Steam suggestion, which are where I usually get my suggestions from. All in all, I think I did a much better with this video than I did with my entry overall. The entry kind of looks like I'm shitting on the anime a lot more than I am here, but that's, like I said, it's because I was in a rush and I wasn't able to plan it out as well as I was hoping. Did I cross this off, actually? I don't think I
did.
Okay, I did cross it off the list. All right, never mind then. Screw that.
Okay, guys, that's going to bring this Thoughts and Opinions to an end on Your Name. Feel free to post your own thoughts and opinions on Your Name in the comment section below. Did you like it? Did you dislike it? And for what different reasons?
Don't forget that you can recommend and suggest any anime you want to me, with a handful of exceptions that won't go on to the list as of right now. But any new suggestions that you make will go on to List 2, and keep in mind that List 2 cannot be accessed until List 1 is completed, unless the items on List 2 are directly tied to a series that I have watched or is on List 1. That way that I can continue to watch all that shit there, and I won't have to wait 20 years to watch the second season or something like that.
I'm going to go ahead and stop the video here in a few minutes. Keep in mind, don't forget what I said at the beginning of the video. If you do want to see what I'm going to be, the next four anime, you basically get to see the next four anime I'm going to be watching, though you don't know in what order. Actually, you do know in what order, because you can look at what I'm watching now, and you'll know that that's coming next.
But all you have to do if you want to spoil yourself on that is go over to my analyst, find the link in the description, click on my anime list section of my profile, and you will see, scroll all the way down to the bottom, you'll see all my planned anime. There should be four. Each time I start. Right now there should only be three because I've already started one. Scroll up to the top section and you'll see the watching list. That's what I'm currently working on. So if you want to see what I'm working on next, that's what's being worked on next. And the next one that I am working on, I will reveal, was one that was picked randomly. Obviously this film I picked by choice because it was something short, so I just pulled it off the list. And the other three anime down there, one of those was a random one, and the other two are chosen by choice. But I'm not going to reveal what they are as of right now. Now, the next series that I am working on is 24 episodes in length, I believe, and I've only watched one episode, and it's going to take me, with how busy I'm going to be over the next couple days, it's probably going to take me a few days before I get close to finishing it, so don't expect the next Thoughts and Opinions video for a little while at the very least. Okay, anyways, guys, thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next Anime Thoughts and Opinions video. Don't forget, if there's anything that I didn't mention here, something I forgot to say, or something that you wanted to hear my opinions on about the film that I didn't mention in the video, post in the comments below and I can either clarify things or I can tell you down there. I'll see you guys in the next Anime Thoughts and Opinions video.